The good news for small businesses is that right now more than 50 governments have active market enablement policies of different types in place to promote renewable energy and actually close that gap between the artificially cheap or less expensive fossil fuels and nuclear, and the, in some cases, for most cases, in the renewables, although they're on steeply descending cost trajectories, they're still costlier if you take that snapshot in time, even though fossil fuels and nuclear are rising in cost and price and renewables are generally coming down in cost and price, you've still got to plug that gap. And that's why governments have a whole variety of different market enablement mechanisms, the most popular one being the feed-in tariff that actually levies a small extra few pence on energy bills per month that then can be used to create a pot of money that's paid as premium pricing for renewably generated electricity. That's the most popular and I think the most successful market enablement process. What it does for a small business is, in the countries that have these tariffs, like Britain, like France, like Germany, like Spain, Italy, is that what you can do is take a roof and turn it into a money-making mechanism, because your premium pricing is guaranteed for 25 years. It's a sovereign guarantee. It's safer than a government bond because you own the asset as well, or you can own the asset if you choose to. And so this is a wonderfully attractive thing. The economic question of what's the payback has gone. It's a question of generating receivables, quite apart from the the strategic reasons you might have for wanting to start getting used to renewable energy or developing a business even in renewable energy. Now, all that said, of course, if you look at the current retail price of electricity and you look at the take solar photovoltaics, the technology I know best, in a country like Britain, even without market enablement, without a feed-in tariff, what you can do with a solar roof is generate electricity that is giving you a return on investment every year, because you're saving on the retail price of brown conventional electricity. And just using that kind of approach, imagining your solar roof as an investment in the bank and comparing it to an investment in the bank, say you've spent £10,000 on your roof, or you compare it with putting £10,000 in a bank account, you actually have an annual return that's better than leaving your money in the bank right now. It'll be about 3 or 4% from a solar roof before the feed-in tariff. And of course, if you put it in the so-called savings accounts run by the bonus cultists, well, what are you going to get? 1%, 2% if you're lucky.